I'm Carolyn Carr. I'm actually trained as a conservation biologist. I live in the neighborhood not far from here. And I've been working with a group of volunteers for nearly 20 years doing restoration here along the gorge with a number of different partner organizations. You know, right now we're standing on the floodplain of the Mississippi River right here in the heart of the Twin Cities. We're in Minneapolis on Minneapolis Park Board land. In the Longfellow neighborhood right across the river is St. Paul. And we're also in a national park, the Mississippi National River and Recreation Area. The thing that you get to see this time of year here in the on the floodplain are some spring ephemerals. These are plants that come up very early in the season, and they have to go through their whole life cycle. They have to flower and get their flowers pollinated, produce seeds, have those seeds dispersed all just within a few weeks. And so this is the moment to be out and see them. So the spring ephemeral we're seeing here is bloodroot, which is one of my favorites, honestly. Like all the spring ephemerals, it comes up very early when the canopy trees don't have leaves yet. There's this short amount of time when there's sun available to those plants. They grow their leaves, they put out their flowers. These flowers only last a day or two. And then the pollinators come, and then the seeds form. And what's great, especially interesting to me, is that each of these seeds has this little fatty tissue on it called an elaiosome, and the ants will come to grab those seeds for that little bit of fatty tissue. They take it back to their ant nests, feed their baby ants, and what ends up happening is that plant is spread by the seeds being spread by those ants gradually from the initial patch. You know, spring ephemerals are important because they provide a pollinator a chance to get pollen early in the season. These plants flower only briefly. They have different kinds of flowers that appeal to different kinds of pollinators. They're part of the whole system of life. But there are also some invading non-native plants that are present. We're looking at a non-native invasive plant, garlic mustard. And this is the older plant. It's a biennial, so the second year it grows larger and spreads its seeds, and you can see the flowers starting to form. And next to it are the seeds from last year that are growing their seedlings this year. And you can see it's a dense carpet. And that's the threat here at this site in the floodplain, is that those seedlings will end up outcompeting the other plants that are here, the native plants that are here. So we're looking at squill. It's one of the invasive plants that's here. It's the one with long, thin leaves, and it has bright blue flowers that are really showy and attractive, but actually it ends up invading areas, creating really dense patches. This is the beginning of one of those dense patches that you can see here, and it's got blue flags on it because we're trying to remove it, to dig them out bulb by bulb, to try to prevent them from spreading, particularly into the patches of bloodroot and other wildflowers that are present here. One of the things that lets us know this is such important habitat is that there's a record of something like 180 species of birds that are using this natural area that's right along the Mississippi River here. And that's because for thousands of years, birds have been migrating right along the Mississippi River corridor. And it's urgently important that we protect the habitat that's right along the Mississippi River for all of those creatures that are relying on it for all of these generations. We want our kids to be able to see places like this. We have to work together to protect them. The work to restore this area right here, this parkland right here in the Longfellow neighborhood, began with a group of neighborhood residents. We learned that there was habitat that was meaningful along this natural area, and we as a community said, wow, let's find some partners and try to work together to protect this site. Not just this site here down at the floodplain, we really started in a different location, but right along this long stretch of natural area, which we're so fortunate to have as part of our neighborhood. We started a little committee, and that committee has been working together for 20 or more years, trying to engage partners, and we've been successful getting assistance from other folks who also want to see natural area protected for all the reasons that it's valuable. So if you're someone who wants to experience the gorge, learn more about spring ephemerals, come, enjoy it, look around, see for yourself what's here. And if you're interested in pitching in on some of the work, please contact some of the partners that are doing these projects. Friends of the Mississippi River is a great example. They're holding events to pull garlic mustard just over my shoulder, out that way, this spring. And then most importantly, whoever you are, please plant native plants in your home yard. You know, we can create our homegrown national parks right here in our yards that complement this habitat that's here and create opportunities for pollinators, for birds, all kinds of creatures to take advantage of those plants that provide them what they need.